Hospital, Dr. Emma, my very good friend and Deputy Director of Health Services, Dr. Musa, and all protocols observed. I want to also speak out of heart. I have worked at Kenyatta National Hospital for 5 years before joining NMS. And the story of blood is a very sad story because every single day there are more than 8 or 9 people that we used to cancel their surgeries. I used to work in the medical ward at level 7 and level 8. And you find that there are people who sometimes they...
And regardless of which station you are, even if you are in the war front, they would dedicate a day for you to donate blood. So we have troops, even in Somalia and Sierra Leone, donating blood to come all the way back to help fellow Kenyans. So this is a very good example that was started in Kenya, and I hope in collaboration with Kenya Blood Transfusion, we'll be able to collaborate and work to help save Kenyan life. The medical superintendent, Dr. Mutio, Director of Health Services, Dr. Oluga, CEO of Life Bank.
They need the cleaning of their wounds, of the treatment, and sadly, they could stay in Kenyatta National Hospital for 2 weeks, for 3 weeks, just because we are waiting for that pint of blood, or just 2 pints of blood, so that they could be taken to theatre. It was a very distressing story that almost it injures even the healthcare worker, because every day you see this patient and you are not able to do something. Out of the women that we lose during childbirth, nearly 50% of them are lost because of something we call postpartum hemorrhage, that is losing of blood excessively during...
The blood supply is critical towards addressing national disasters and saving lives. The passing of 2010 Constitution devolved healthcare to address gaps in healthcare and ensure equity and access to all citizens. Blood transfusion is an essential component of healthcare, which saves millions of lives each year. Despite ongoing efforts, it will still be many years before artificial substitutes can routinely replace the need of donated human blood. Even though blood is universally required for management of patients, the pattern of blood usage differs significantly across the globe. Nairobi requires an estimated 50,000 units of blood to cater for arising medical needs among 1% of Kenya's population that resides in the city, and we are not able to adequately meet our needs, especially now with COVID pandemic situation. The arrival of COVID-19 pandemic has made it difficult to address blood collection gaps, but has offered more opportunities to build more resilience and sustainable health infrastructure. With COVID-19 vaccine deployed, we are at a turning point. We are excited about Life Bank investing in Kenya as the third country after Nigeria and Ethiopia, and especially starting of blood engagement at NMS in Nairobi County with our public hospital, Mama Lucy Kibaki Hospital, the first blood collection center in Nairobi metropolitan area. As Dr. Nduku said, this will not be the last, and she has...
After child labor, and we could save up to 90% of them if we got them blood on time. So it's a very sad story, because for healthcare workers who are here, and I'm sure my senior Dr. Nganga would agree with this, sometimes you want to do your best, but because there is no blood, you have to postpone the surgery. When you postpone the surgery, either the cancer is getting worse or a life is lost. So many times we have to discharge or let patients go home at Kenyatta National Hospital. Machines that require prefills so that we could be able to do everything here, that is separation of blood to have some of the products, so that in the very near future we do not have even to take some of the specimens to the National Blood Transfusion Center for screening. With those very many remarks, I want to thank you again.